But Black Power leader Stokely Carmichael warned a press conference in Washington that white America would pay in blood for the death of Martin Luther King.
When white America killed Dr. King last night, she opened the eyes for every black man in this country. When white America got rid of Marcus Garvey, she did it and she said he was an extremist. He was crazy. When they got rid of Brother Malcolm X, they said he was preaching hate. He deserved what he got. But when they got rid of Brother Martin Luther King, they had absolutely no reason to do so. He was the one man in our race who was trying to teach our people to have love, compassion, and mercy for what white people had done. When white America killed Dr. King last night, she declared war on us. There will be no crying, there will be no funerals. The rebellions that have been occurring around the cities of this country is just lights up to what is about to happen. We have to retaliate for the death of our leaders. The execution of those deaths will not be in the courtrooms. They're going to be in the streets of the United States of America. When white America killed Dr. King last night, she made a whole lot easier for a whole lot of black people today. There no longer needs to be intellectual discussions. Black people know that they have to get guns. White America will live to cry that she killed Dr. King last night. It would have been better if she had killed Rack Brown and or Stokely Carmichael. But when she killed Dr. King, she lost.
The worst wave of civil violence ever to hit America burst in cities all over the country. An orgy of vandalism, fire-raising, looting, and killing broke out in retribution for the loss of Dr. King.